Hello students, myself Dr. Jyoti Shegokar. I welcome you all in my YouTube channel Dr. Jyoti Dhumale Shegokar, which is made for the study of engineering chemistry. Now today we have to see the topic under this heading of engineering chemistry, that is corrosion. I have given here number of videos on this particular topic. So today's topic is type of wet corrosion. So we have seen in the last lecture in which we have studied wet corrosion. So in that we have seen that wet corrosion, it is also called as an electrochemical corrosion, and electrochemical corrosion can be of two types. One is the galvanic corrosion that we have to see just now, and another is the concentration cell corrosion. So first of all we will see this galvanic corrosion. Now galvanic corrosion, it is that corrosion in which two separate areas are formed in the two different media. So how the two separate areas are formed for the undergoing corrosion process? We know that first of all corrosion, it is nothing but the example we can give, that rusting of iron. That means any metal when revert back into its original state, that is the state of ore or mineral, means in the mixed state, that is called as a inverse of extraction or corrosion. So wet corrosion, it is having somewhat different way to undergo this process. So just for an example, if this is a metal strip and this metal strip is to be corroded, it is placed into the medium. So what will happen here, there is a formation of two different electrodes, cathode and anode. It may be like this, two different parts of the metal, or it may be like this, two different parts of the metal, anode and cathode. And from this, anode will be corroded. That is because particularly process of oxidation occurs on the anode. So oxidation is nothing but removal of electrons. So anode removes electron which are accepted by cathode, and cathode portion will totally get protected. That is the actually wet corrosion. Now how that wet corrosion is possible, what are the different circumstances which are possibly undergoes the make the corrosion to be happen. So here just we can see that there is a particular experimentation, or we can give such type of diagram. Here there is a particularly water or any type of liquid which is electrolyte or which is electrolytic in nature. That means it should flow the electrons from one to another, it should flow the ions. Now here there is a particular this container which is having the electrolyte, and in this what we have put, see here, there are two different types of electrodes. One is made by zinc, another is made by copper, and these two electrodes are connected with each other from this particular portion. So they are connected electrically with each other and dip partially into the electrolytic media. So it is shown in the figure. So whenever such a condition is there, that the particular both type of metals are there, and they are both, as they are in nature of metal, they must be corroded. So which part will get corroded and which part will get protected, that is the question. So whenever two different electrodes are connected electrically and dipped partially like this into the electrolytic media, in this case those metal which is having its oxidation potential higher will act as an anode. So in this example of zinc and copper, zinc is having a higher oxidation potential, that's why zinc will undergo the process of oxidation and gets corroded by acting as an anode. So whenever we write zinc, it is just as a Zn. So when Zn undergoes the process of oxidation, it will lose two electrons to form Zn di positive. Plus these two electrons can be written like this, it is called as a process of oxidation. So particularly zinc will get corroded. Why this is so? It is because zinc is having higher electrode potential than copper, than its adjacent partner metal or electrode. So these electrons which are removed by zinc by the oxidation are obviously accepted by this copper di positive ion to becomes copper as a neutral. It means that why it is shown as a neutral? because it is get protected totally. So this is called as a process of oxidation. And as there is a this particular media is there, this total circuit gets completed, because electrons are removed by this metal and they are flown through this media towards the another one, and in this way total process is going on. So totally those portion which is having higher electrode potential gets corroded, while which is having lower electrode potential gets protected. In this way there occurs the galvanic cell corrosion, and this particular method is a aeration method actually. Thank you.